Hello students, welcome back to your science class. So students, in the previous class in this chapter we have started with the new chapter, and that is force and laws of motion. So in this chapter, as the name of the chapter is force and laws of motion, so we have started to understand the concept of force. What is a force, students? Force is basically if we push or pull anything, that we called as force. Okay, so if we are applying, or we are pushing an object, or if we are trying to pull an object, we can make a movement in the body, and that we will call as because of the force only these changes happen. Later on, here in the same concept, we have understood that what are the different effect of force. So basically, the effect of force included that because of force only, there is a change in the movement, like an object which is at a stationary or which is at rest starts moving. Object which is moving because of force can comes to rest. An object can change shape and size. An object can change the direction. An object can change the speed because of the force. We have understood that what are the different examples also in order to understand all the different effect of forces. Suppose the object is at rest. If it is a football or a ball is there, and a footballer or a person kick the ball, what happened? The ball start moving. So why does it happen? Because of the force applied by the footballer, force applied by the person, due to which it start moving. Anything which is at rest, it start moving because of a force applied on it. Second one, object is moving and we came because of force, we can make it to come to rest. If a ball is coming towards a fielder will catch it, and ultimately it will make a moving object to stop. Here, because of a force applied to it, so if an object is moving, students, so we can apply force on it, and by applying force we can stop that object. Third one, by applying force we can change the direction. So if a ball is moving towards the batsman, then with the help of the bat, by applying force on the batsman can change the direction. So this is also because of the force applied by him. So we can say here that force applied will help us in changing the direction. Then the next one is, we can take another example, like a tennis player is there, he is playing tennis. So with the help of a tennis racket, he can change the direction of the tennis ball which is coming towards him. Fourth one is, with the help of a force, we can change the shape and size of an object. You see, if you are having a rubber band, by applying force you can stretch it. Or a spring is there, or a sponge is there. So what will happen? By applying force on it, we can change the shape and size of that object. And finally, by applying force, we can increase or decrease the speed. So if suppose a bicycle is there, and if you push the bicycle from behind, it will start moving fast. It means there will be increase in the speed. But if you start pulling the bicycle from behind, this will decreases the speed. So we can say here that by applying force on the bicycle, we are able to increase or to decrease the speed of the bicycle. These are some of the effect of the force. Now on that basis, now there is another definition of the force come, and that is, a force is an influence. A force is an influence. It is an influence which tends to set, which tends to set, which tends to set a stationary body a stationary body, a stationary body in motion, in motion, or stop a moving body, stop a moving body to rest, moving body to rest, or which tends to, which tends to change the speed and direction, to change the speed and direction, change the speed and direction, tends to change the speed and direction of a moving body, of a moving body, or which tends to change the shape and size of a body. Okay, so force is what? It is an influence which tends, which make an object to, if it is a stationary, so in motion, or in a motion, then it comes to rest, and or which tends to change the speed and direction of a moving body. It can changes, it can increase or decreases the speed of a body, or as well as it will also, because of the force only, there can be change in the direction can also occur. And finally, yes, because of the force, there will be change in the shape and size of the body, students. Okay, this is the definition of the force. So till now we have seen that force is what? Any object, if you are pushing or pulling it, push or pull on an object is called as force. But now we have seen a new definition in which all these things happens, then yes, we will say force occurs. Now there are two different types of a force also. The first one is balanced force, second one is unbalanced force. So let us see what are the two different type of a force. Balanced and unbalanced force. Balanced and unbalanced force. Balanced and unbalanced force, students. Now let us start with the first one, and that is balanced force. Talking about a balanced force, let us define what is a balanced force. So, if the resultant of all the forces acting on a body is zero, the force are called balanced force. The force are called balanced force. So the resultant of all the forces which is acting on a body is zero. Then the force, that kind of a force is called as balanced force. Okay. So here we can say that if an object is there, suppose at a table a box is kept there and this box is not moving at all. Okay. This is a kind of a box which is kept on a table here. Now, what happened? Why this box is not moving, students? It is because there is a force acting on the book which make it to do not change its state, that is state of rest. So, the forces which is acting on it, all the forces are equal and opposite. That's why they are, the resultant force is zero, and this kind of a force is called as balanced force. Okay, so here, so one of the force which is acting on it is force of friction. Force of friction. The second one is, that is force of our push. Then next one is force of gravity, that is weight. That is weight. And force of reaction. Force of reaction. So, force of friction is there, force of our push is there, force of gravity, which is weight, and finally, force of reaction. These are the four different kind of a force which is acting on the box, and because of that, the box is not moving at all. And all these forces are equal and opposite. It means, therefore, if we are applying a force on the object and if it is still not moving, remember that here the force of friction is equal to our force of push, and that's why it cancels each other, resultant becomes zero and ultimately it is not moving. Here, two more forces are acting on the book. That is one of the force because of its weight. That is a force of gravity. And another force is there which is just opposite to this reaction. That is force of reaction. And these two forces are also equal and opposite. That is why they cancel each other. Ultimately, we can say here that all the forces which is acting on the box, they cancel each other. They are equal and opposite. And thus, they are, we can say that, thus the box is not moving. Thus, the resultant force is zero. And finally, this kind of a force is called as balanced force. Okay, anything student, if it is at a rest position and as well as if it is moving with the uniform motion, there also the kind of a force which is acting on it is a balanced force. Okay, so this is the balanced force. Now let us take an example to understand here one more thing. Suppose you have taken a balloon and you are using both of your hand in order to press it. Now, with this hand also you are applying the same amount of force. With this hand also you are applying the same amount of force. Now, with both of the hand you are applying the force on it. So, what will happen? The shape of the balloon will change. So, even though you are applying an equal and opposite amount of a force on it, But it does not move, but there will be change in the shape occur. So we can say that in balanced force, the object either do not move or do not stop if it is moving, but it changes its shape. So here I should add in another point, and that is that is though balanced force balanced forces cannot produce motion in a stationary body or stop a moving body, but it can change the shape of a body. However, it can change the shape of a body. Okay, so balanced forces was student in which we have understood here that in which all the forces which is acting on it making the resultant force zero, such kind of a force is a balanced force. Moving on, and let us see the another kind of a force, and that is unbalanced force. Unbalanced force. Now the name itself says unbalanced. It means here the resultant force is not zero. It do not nullify each other, but yes, one of the forces is greater than the other force. So if the resultant force acting on a body is not zero, then the force are called unbalanced force. Then the force are called unbalanced forces. Okay. Now here one more thing, and that is an unbalanced force can make a stationary body to move or stop a moving body. Stationary body to move or stop a moving body. Now let us see how does it happen, students. So suppose again here a car is there. Suppose a car is there
a toy car is there, suppose. A toy car is there. And here in this car, students, when we apply a force on it, what happened? We are pushing it. So there is a force which is because of our push. Force of our push. This is another force which is acting on it is force of friction. There is a force which is acting on a gravity because of its weight, that is force of gravity in the downward direction. Force of gravity. And finally, force of reaction. Force of reaction. So, these are the forces again acting on this toy car also. Now, let us see what happened in the unbalanced force. Here, any of the one force is greater than the other. Suppose you try to push a toy car and starts moving. So at first is what it was at rest, but because of your push, it start moving. What does that it tell, student? It tells that the force that you had applied here, because of your force, the force of your push is greater than the force of a friction here. Okay, so here the force of friction is lesser than that of the force of our push. And if out of the two forces, if one of the forces is greater, so resultant will not equal to zero because it will not going to nullify each other. The force is not equal. It is opposite but not equal. So there is some value of the force, meaning it makes the toy car to move. Now, the toy car is moving with the uniform motion, remember, with the uniform motion. And then you apply a force by pulling it back. Now it stops. So here, the force that you had applied was greater, and because of that, it made that moving body to stop. So this is how we can say here that a unbalanced force is the force where the resultant force is not equal to zero. It means the forces which is acting on a particular body, one of the force will be greater than the other, making the force unbalanced, giving value to the force, help in making the resultant force not equal to zero, and ultimately it will make the object either to move or moving object to stop. Okay, so this is what this is about, the unbalanced force here. Now here, a lot of example are there, students, to understand the unbalanced force. One more thing, whenever we talk about that a force is acting on a body, we never use that for a balanced force. We know that whenever we are applying a force on an object, starts moving, changes speed or changes the direction. So this is what this is. Since we are making a change in it, that's why it will comes under unbalanced force. So whenever we say that a force is applied on an object, it means there we are talking about the unbalanced force only. Okay. Now, many times you have seen, students, that you are riding with a cycle, and when you apply a force, because of that you start moving. So remember here what happened. When you start paddling, you are applying a force on the paddle. So that is your force of push. You are applying a force, and in return a force of friction is also there, which makes the cycle tire not to move. But because your force is greater than the force of friction, so you start moving, your cycle start moving. Now, right now you are not paddling, you are still on a cycle, you are moving, but you are not paddling. What happened? A few after, if you are not paddling, it will move and slowly its speed decreases, finally it will stop. Same thing happened with the ball. Even if you have catch it, then you have stopped it. But if you haven't catch or you do not touch the ball, if it is moving on a plain ground, a smooth ground, so what will happen? It will move and finally it will get stopped. without using a force by you. So how does it happen? Here also a force is working, and that is force of friction. So we will say that now the force of friction is greater than the force of our push, so it stops. So this is what, this is all about the unbalanced force. So we have understood the concept of a balanced force and unbalanced force. Like, we can take a very easy example for both of them, last example, tug of war. In a tug of war, there are two teams, students, okay? Team A and team B is there. If the force applied by team A is equals to team B, at that time, none of them will move to any side. And this kind of a force is a balanced force. But if any of the team is applying more force than the other one, so other one will start moving towards the team who has applied more force. So the movement occurred, this will tell it is because of the unbalanced force, because one of the team has applied more force than the other, so there is not a balanced force acting between the two team, that's why one of the team moves. So this is the balanced and unbalanced force. In exam, a lot of questions ask what is balanced or unbalanced force. Even the question can be asked, can you give an example to make the concept clear? Okay, so this is about the force, different type of a force. Now let us move on and we will see the other topic of this chapter, and that is laws of motion. Laws of motion. So actually there are three laws of motion, students, and these all laws of motion was given by Newton. Newton has described the motion of the body, and this description involved the three laws. So we can say now we will going to study about the Newton's laws of motion. Okay, Newton's laws of motion. So he has described the motion of a body with the help of a three law. Now let us start with the first law of motion. Okay, first law. First law of motion. What is the first law? Let us write it that a body at rest will remain at rest a body at motion will remain at motion a body at motion will remain at motion in a straight line with the uniform speed unless it compelled by an external force, compelled by an external force to change its state of rest or of motion, its state of rest or of motion. Okay, this is the Newton's first law of motion. Body at rest will remain at rest. Body at motion will remain at motion in a straight line with a uniform speed until and unless an external force is compelled to change the state of rest or of motion.